Hello everyone, and congratulations for the Braves who stayed until the very last minute while the sun is shining outside finally today. So I'll try to introduce some recent results that we have obtained lately on the scaling properties of traffic in communication network, and in the course I will try to convince you that the statistical analysis and more generally the probabilistic analysis of traffic is of paramount importance whenever we want to understand first the mechanisms of the underlying complex systems like networks, but not only, and when we also try to come up with new protocols, new mechanisms, new management policies to try to cope with the properties, with the features of those traffics. And in this direction, I will finish the talk trying very concretely to show you how we can leverage the knowledge that we got on the statistical description of the traffic so as to come up with new policies that take into account the specificities of the system itself. And I have to give credit to this work also to my collaborators, and principally to Shubhra Bharata Roy, who is a PhD student that actually should have defended in 2013, but since we are asking a lot, he's still working. And some other colleagues, Patrick Loiseau was also a former PhD student of mine, who is now associate professor, and Thomas Bégin, who is working in the same institute as I'm working. Okay, so the idea of the work that we have been achieving so far is in the vein of a very long tradition of statistical people and researchers working on the understanding and the characterization of traffic processes. It started 100 years ago or so when the phone system came up. And the first to be interested in understanding how we could characterize the voice at the time signal was essentially Erlang, who came up with the idea that a good model for this circuit switching system was to consider a Poisson process. What characterizes essentially the Poisson process is that it is a memoryless process, in the sense that the statistical dependence between the signal at a given time and the same signal at epsilon time afterwards or before are totally independent from a statistical point of view. Later on, when the web came up, when the internet came up, when TCP protocols came up, and more generally when switching packet switching networks